Oh, are we back? I'm sorry. I'm busy talking to Jim.
We're having fun.
Tony, how could you interrupt me like this? You know? Good grief, looking at me like, why aren't you talking? Your mic is hot. I'm a busy woman. I have to catch up with Jim.
Yeah.
For the Facebook audience, take a look at this. Isn't this amazing? Came out August 16th. Is this true? This has got to be a typo. 55th anniversary?
55 years. We formed in 1964. And even throughout all the Survivor years, we never stopped playing. So we're holding some kind of a record for the longest running band with its original four members that had like a major top 10 record with Vehicle.
I can't believe that, you know, because let's face it, a lot of rock and roll bands, as we've discussed, they get a little, they're like families. They're like, they get to be like dysfunctional families. And after a while, they really don't want to talk to each other. I can't believe you got the same band together.
I know. Well, we just rehearsed this morning, which is why my voice is a little hoarse. But we had a little argument this morning about nothing. But we always patch it up. And if you don't argue, you don't communicate, you know. And we always, at the end of the day, we always shake hands and go, well, you're right and I'm right and this is the way we'll do it.
You know, Jim, you have so much good music that you could just do, you could tour the country over and over again with everything you've got. Why go to all the work to do brand new stuff?
Wow. Well, it's funny. I have this conversation with so many of the classic rockers that I'm friends with and toured with through the years, whether it's Kevin Cronin or Dennis DeYoung, or so many of them say, why make a record? And I'm the cheerleader going, because that's what we do. That's what gets us off, you know.
And you know, I've got to say, I mean, I understand what an undertaking it is, but I really admire you for that. I mean, Ray was telling me that The Who are coming out with a brand new album. And did you hear Roger Daltrey's quote? He's like, we're old, we don't care. We're going to do what we want to do. Buy it, don't buy it, we don't care.
See, that's the spirit.
That's rock and roll.
It really is. Because when we were 15, we weren't doing demographic surveys to see what was going to sell. We wanted to impress those girls. We wanted to get on stage and kick butt. And we're still the same guys.
And these days, it seems like if you really want a music career, you start on YouTube or Instagram.
I know. You know, that's the new thing. It's harder to get signed nowadays. You have to build up a huge following on the internet. And then Sony or Warner Bros. Might consider you.
Yeah. And it seems to be, that seems to be the litmus test. Not who's heard your music. Not whether or not anybody in the A&R department thinks that you've got some songwriting talent. Oh, how many followers? How many followers do they have? I was reading an interview with a famous actor who said that they, you know, they had done some project and they had to go back and reshoot some scenes, and there was a new actor, and the guy was like, who's this? And he's like, oh, they're an influencer.
I hate that word. I know.
So we're, you know, and the guy goes, I don't know whether the influencer's scene got in there, but it was all because you got a lot of followers on social media, so we'll put you in the movie. Oh, it's a brave new world, Jim.
Brave is a very kind word.
it's a very strange new
world.
Sorry, I'm sounding a bit like a crabby dinosaur, aren't
I? Kids, get off my lawn.
So, why did you do this? I mean, you woke up one day and you were like, you know what? I'm going to see if those guys will come back and, you know, go in the studio with me, and we're going to do this all over again.
Well, you know, the ads always stayed recording. The real difference with this record, Joan, is that we hired a producer. We haven't been produced since back in the day, 1970, 71, 73, our heyday, when we had Vehicle and we had a producer that, you know, kept us in line. We were kids. There's something about having an outside ear. And we hired Fred Mullen, who has done everyone from America to Linda Ronstadt to Jimmy Webb. He was a friend of mine, you know, and he came in and really took the reins. And, you know, if Jimmy Peterik, me, writes a new song that sucks, he's not afraid to say it. where the other guys will be, they'll be walking on eggshells. So it's our best album that we've done. And we were so confident that we asked some people to be our guests on it. Mark Farner with Grand Funk Railroad, mm-hmm. who is mm-hmm. a force of nature. Just so talented. We wrote a song called Swagger together, did a video, which is out there on YouTube and Facebook right now. He's coming into this big show we're doing, which I know you're going to help me plug.
Absolutely.
October 26th.
By the way, I also plug Swagger. We played it at the very beginning of the broadcast.
You're awesome.
Yeah, I love that. I was listening to all the tracks.
Yeah, thank you.
I love that track.
Well, we wrote that together, Mark Farner and I, because I wrote it about him, because he a lot of times he's a guest on my show, at like on stage with the Ides or World Stage. He gets up there, and he's not real tall, but you never realize that he's only 5'9" or whatever. He's a monster. He's got the swagger, and that's what mm-hmm. that song's all about.
That's a big part of rock and roll. My partner, he's got a band. Mostly they play gigs and they do, you know, charity stuff, and they played in New York, and afterwards I said, that one guy, I don't know if he's the bass player, I was like, he's got to go. He stands there like a cement statue. And I said, does he really hates being in the band, right? And Ray was like, no. And I go, he looks like that he would rather be any place else in the world than on stage. I'm sorry, when somebody's on stage, I want to know that you, the performer, are enjoying being up there. That sells it to me in a way that makes the music that much better.
Well, you should come to see the Ides. We are having so much fun. I mean, we take it really seriously, but we also have a blast, and that's a good combination. It's all about the spirit on that stage. And other people on this album, Bo Bice, who sang, he was the runner-up to number one on American Idol.
After Carrie Underwood.
Carrie Underwood.
If you're going to get beaten by somebody,
yeah, right,
that's
exactly.
Not bad.
And the great thing about that is he one of the main songs he sang was Vehicle.
Really?
And he killed it, you know. And we've been in touch ever since. And since then, he joined Blood, Sweat, and Tears. Very ironic, because Blood, Sweat, and Tears used to encore with Vehicle, which is ironic because everyone thought Vehicle was BS&T. And it was really the Ides of March. But so we tapped into him, and we wrote a song together for this record play on. It's called Love or Something Like It. He's going to be at the Genesee also on October 26th. And tickets still available.
Oh, we're going to plug it. Don't worry.
I know you are.
GeneseeTheater.com.
Mm-hmm.
Saturday, October 26th. That's a beautiful. You've been up there
before?
Oh,
yeah.
It's a beautiful theater.
It's one of the classic 1920s.
Yeah.
Totally
and
restored.
Restored it. It's amazing.
It's one of the best.
Mm-hmm.
And the sound.
You can go up early. There's a couple of little restaurants right by there.
I know.
Mm-hmm.
Get a couple of drinks.
Place.
Sure.
Even better for a rock and roll show.
Well, you know, you need a little.
Okay, I have to take a commercial break.
Okay.
Should we play something from the album that you sent me, or do you want to play us out live?
Well, I'll play a little live.
Okay.
All right. This is one that's for George Bliss, who called me up and said, would you do this show? I'll just do a little of the L.A. Goodbye. This is a big hit by the Ides, 1971. Well, my wavelength gets a little long. Every time my wave gets by, sentimental breakdown. You know I break down a lot. Where I'm not supposed to lie my head, always see myself disappear. And as I board my plane, something inside my brain hates to wave LA goodbye. And they goodbye.
That was beautiful. If you would like to talk to Jim, the number is 773-763-9278. We will be back with much more after this.
With your Mayo Clinic Radio Health Minute, I'm Vivian Williams. According to the U.S. Census Bureau, by the year 2030, there will be 70 million adults over the age of 65 in America. This aging population has its own unique health issues and complications and will require specialized geriatric care.
In older adults, we really concentrate on the functional status, how they're able to move, how they're able to think, how they're able to get along at home. A lot of times when we talk with people or see people in the office, we really look at how well they're able to mobilize. How are they able to actually walk in the office? Are they using a cane? Are they using a wheelchair?
Dr. Paul Takahashi says house calls are becoming more common, especially to help less mobile patients make their living space safer.
Trying to make sure there's good lighting, make sure they're going to get rid of all the kind of the trip risks and the fall risks. Those are really critical as we go into the house. We talk with people about that and make sure we do kind of basic safety evaluation.
Hopefully preventing health issues before they happen. For more information, talk with your doctor or visit mayoclinic.org.
Joan Esposito and Jim Peterik are brought to you live, local, and progressive in part by Hawk Volkswagen on Jefferson Street, just east of I-55 in Joliet, and Hawk Chrysler Dodge Jeep on Roosevelt Road in Forest Park. Save money, save time. HawkVW.com and HawkJeep.com.
Hi, I'm Raymond Denon, Vice President of Optima Tax Relief. If you're in debt to the IRS, there's a lot you need to know. Starting with rule number one, don't mess with the IRS. They can garnish your paycheck, levy your bank accounts, even take your home or business. That's all true. But it's also true that there's a way out. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative. It's one of the biggest breaks the IRS has ever offered. If you qualify, you could save thousands, even tens of thousands. Nobody knows this program like us, the experts at Optima Tax Relief. We have an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau, and we've resolved over $500 million in tax debt for our clients. We'll stand between you and the IRS and fight to get you the best deal possible. Don't mess with the IRS. For tax help you need, for tax help you can trust, call Optima for a free consultation.
Call 800-367-6289. 800-367-6289. 800-367-6289.
Optima Tax Relief.
Some restrictions apply. For complete details, please visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
WCPT is proud to support labor unions and the hardworking middle class. I'm launching a brand new hour-long segment, Union Strong. Join me as I welcome respected labor leaders to my show each week. We'll get their perspective on current events, local and national politics, and how labor unions are more relevant than ever. Don't miss Union Strong each week on Live, Local, and Progressive with Joan Esposito on WCPT 820. Learn more at WCPT820.com.
A library card is the first step toward lifelong learning. Today's libraries provide more than just books. From story times, family game nights, and cooking classes, to opportunities to borrow audiobooks and museum passes, there's something for everyone at the library. September is Library Card Sign-Up Month, the perfect time to explore what your library has to offer. Visit your library or ilovelibraries.org today. This is a message from the American Library Association.
WCPT 820, Chicago's progressive talk, where facts matter.
Joan Esposito, live, local, and progressive on WCPT 820.
You find a lot of...
We're back on. Jim and I are having a conversation. Oh, yes. I'm sorry. We really are having a hard time getting back from these breaks. By the way, we got a text. Let me see. I even want my contacts in again. Somebody congratulating you and saying that they're a fan and they follow you. By the way, if you want to learn more about the band, they have their own website, theidesofmarch.com. So you can go there. But if you want tickets for the show, you've got to go to GenesseeTheater.com because that's where they're going to be Saturday, October 26th. Now, you said something, Jim. You said the Ides never really broke up. You guys were always in touch. But where did Survivor, how does Survivor come into all that?
Well, we took a kind of a hiatus in 73, but we never stopped playing. Every year we'd play something, whether it was a wedding or a party or whatever. and then I had this idea of forming a brand new band that would be more in the mold of like Foreigner, you know, or Kansas or Toto, because I love that kind of music too. Mm-hmm. And that's when I created Survivor in 1978 with Frankie Sullivan. And that became, you know, enormous at one point. We had two albums that really stiffed. And then lo and behold, I got the phone call that changed my life. Answering machine, I pick it up. when I hear, "Hey, yo, Jim, give me a call at Sylvester Stallone."
As one so often hears on your voicemail.
I'm sure you got them.
But, yeah.
And I was like, "No, get it. Shut the door. Come on." And my wife says, "Who is that?" I said, "Oh, some guy impersonating Stallone." And I finally called him back. I said, "Is this really Sylvester Stallone? This is Jim Peterik." He goes, "Hey, Jimbo, call me Sly." And it went from there, man. And he says, "I got this new movie called Rocky III. And I don't want to use that Going to Fly Now song again. I want something new for the kids, man. Something with a pulse." Exactly what he said. "Can you help me out?" I said, "Hell yeah." And he said, "I'm going to send you the first 3 minutes of the movie. It's the montage with Mr. T and me, you know. And I want you to write an anthem, a world-beating anthem that will last longer than we do on this earth. Can you help me?" I said, "Yeah, no problem." I mean, he gave me some strict orders, man.
I thought, I always thought that he'd heard the song and decided to use it for the movie. He called you up and said, "Write me a song, write me an anthem?"
Correct.
Whoa.
He commissioned us to do it. I called up Frankie Sullivan, the guitar player in Survivor. We rented a big Betamax probe, set it up on my kitchen table in LaGrange,
Illinois. Betamax. Folks, for those of you who are younger, we used to record things on these devices called Betamax machines. Okay, proceed.
Right. But this was a pro. It was even bigger. It was like a microwave oven. And you know, we just watched that montage at the beginning. Mr. T's rising up. Stallone's getting kind of soft doing MasterCard commercials, you know. And I had my guitar on my neck, and it just started going, you know. Then I was trying to time the punches with the chords, and I just kind of went. Wait for the punch right here. And we were off to the races, man.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's amazing. So he sent you this trailer, and you actually took the cadence of that trailer and put it into the song.
Correct. And then we had to beg him to send us the whole movie, because he only sent us 3 minutes. And he said, "Oh, I can't do it, man. You know, I got the movie company." I said,
"I love your soul.
I said, Sly, if you want your world-beating anthem, you got to send us the whole movie." So, okay, you know, next day, FedEx, boom, you know. Put it in, and that's when it all made sense. And that's when you hear Rocky's trainer, Mickey, going, "Rocky, you're losing the eye of the tiger. Hello."
Oh,
and it all flowed from there. And a month later, we were on the red carpet in Hollywood for the big premiere, or a month and a half, and people going crazy. And, you know, I mean, I'm not that surprised that song made it to number one for 7 weeks on Billboard that year. So we had the best movie in the world to promote it, right?
Mm-hmm.
But what amazes me is that it's still around.
Oh, my gosh. Mm-hmm. Are you kidding? It's everywhere. even the young kids, even, you know, my kids will hear a song like that and they'll think it's new.
I know. And they love it.
I know.
That's really the best reward we could get.
We got a text from somebody who wanted to know if you ever partied with Stallone.
Oh, man.
I even don't. You know, Jim, remember? We got FCC rules. So, you know, right, think through this story you're going to tell.
You know what? Truthfully, we hung out together at dinner, and always the best of fun. But if that person would have asked me if I ever partied with Led Zeppelin, it would be a different party.
Actually, we have a text about that, too. So, yeah. Okay, go
there
now.
Oh, my God. Well, there's nothing X-rated because we're Berwyn guys. And we opened up for Led Zeppelin in 71, and Run Vehicle was number one. And we opened up for them in Winnipeg. And we had the night of our lives. We played. The people were giving the standing ovations. They had a good night, but they weren't really on their game. Nonetheless, they invited us to the big party afterwards in their penthouse suite. You know, we were probably staying in the Motel 6, you know, they're in the penthouse. And they opened the door. Robert Plant actually opened the door. And he was in his bikini briefs, and we looked beyond, and there was all sorts of, it was like an orgy, okay? And things were happening. We never saw anything like this. We're boys from Berwyn, man, you know? And we were very politely watching, and we weren't indulging in any of the stuff. And at a point, I look at Mike. Mike looks at me and Bob, and we go, we're out of here. We went across the street for donuts, honest to God. And you know what? That's maybe why we're still here. We didn't do that.
That's definitely.
We just didn't do that.
You said something interesting. You said that night that you felt that Led Zeppelin was maybe having an off night. What does that mean when you're on stage? What makes an off night?
Attitude. You know, the PA was awful. We don't care. We were used to playing crappy clubs, so we didn't really care. But Zeppelin was used to this great stuff. And this particular stadium is a hockey arena, had a really bad PA, bad monitors, everything. So they came on with a real hangdog attitude and basically just sleptwalked through the show. The Ides, we opened for them. We didn't care. We gave it 150%. The people loved it. The headline the next day, Ides of March steals show from Led Zeppelin. I still
really?
Have the newspaper. So that was a proud, proud day in the Ides history.
Now, how did you get tapped for that? How does a band like Led Zeppelin choose an opening act? Or does it based like, oh, we're both with the same record company, so we're going to give these guys a break?
Or? Well, that's a real good question. All I know is we had a number one record at the time, and somehow we got attached to all these pop festivals that were happening that summer. You know, we played with Janis Joplin, the Guess Who, Jimi Hendrix, the Grateful Dead, Poco, a Who's Who. Every week we're in a different festival, and they were one of them.
Wow. That's amazing. I have so many more things that I want to ask you, but believe it or not, we're up against another commercial break. And why don't you choose something to play us out to the next commercial break? Jim Peterik, Ides of March, Genesee Theater, October 26th. Take it away, as they say in showbiz.
Yes. Well, this is from the new album Play On. This is one we'll be playing at the Genesee. And it's got a little bit of country flavor to it. I hope you enjoy this. It's called Too Far to Turn Around. My reflection in the window is someone who I'm just about to meet. I've seen the miles I've left behind, the clouds of dust I stirred up on the street. Don't want to waste another moment. Wake up and wonder where the time went. Can't take the easy out, the braver route is calling out my name. I'm on the road to where I've never been, beyond the borders of imagining. This story is my life, I own the movie rights. This passport is my faith, the shoes I wear tonight. I am on the road and I am tired in. I don't know who I am or where I'm bound, but I've come too far to turn around. Gotta take it all the way now. I'm on the road to where I've never been.
Think Theory Radio.
We're also joined by Ray Young, president of the Chicago Archaeological Society.
For those people that don't know this, Illinois has pyramids. I tell people that and they look at me like, huh, what? What do you mean? We should be learning that in school if that's really true. Yeah, we should have been learning that in school. And it is really true. They are impressive. And the largest archaeological site in the United States, from what I understand, is Cahokia.
Think Theory Radio with Damian Perdue. Saturdays at 6 p.m. on WCPT 820.
This is John Daniel, the sheet metal workers of Smart Local 265. You may know the Smart Union member as the hero that fixed your AC on the hottest day of the summer, or the professional you trust to heat your home on the coldest of winter days. Of course, Smart Union members install and maintain the equipment that keeps you comfortable. But did you know that sheet metal workers of Smart Local 265 also construct the systems that keep you safe at work and in your communities? We build the clean rooms where pharmaceuticals are developed and manufactured. We certify surgical suites and isolation rooms to maintain the environment in its most critical settings. Smart members install and test smoke and fire management systems in practically every building you or your loved one sets foot in, giving you a path to safety in a situation where every second counts. The next time a sheet metal worker of Smart Local 265 is in your home to keep you comfortable, know they are also the ones that keep you safe, and that's smart. Learn more at smart265.org.
Warning, this product contains nicotine. Nicotine is an addictive chemical, not for sale to minors. Website restricted to adults 21 and over.
Let's be real. Most smokers aren't looking for some overcomplicated vaping machine. That's why we created MyBlu. MyBlu is simple. Our pre-filled liquid pods mean there's no mess. One charge and MyBlu lasts all day. And with our range of flavors and nicotine options, you have a choice. MyBlu answers on what matters for smokers. Real nicotine satisfaction. And right now, try MyBlu for $1 at select retailers or MyBlu.com.
I'm Jessica Ettinger, CNBC. Stocks wrapped up the last trading day of summer in the red. The Dow fell 0.5%, down 160 points. After low-level trade talks with China in Washington, D.C., fell apart. President Trump said he doesn't need a trade deal to be reelected. Walmart's e-cigarette inventory may be running low soon. It says it'll no longer sell the vaping products after inventory sells out. More than 500 people have been hospitalized with lung disease in the U.S., 8 deaths now. Doctors think it's all related to vaping. Apple's new iPhone 11s may be a hit, with decent pre-orders and some lines this morning when they got into stores. General Motors and suppliers are idling plants. Thousands more people are off the job in Canada. Nearly 50,000 American UAW union workers are now a week into their strike against the company. New in theaters, Fox's Ad Astra, Focus Features' Downton Abbey, and Lionsgate's Rambo.
Hear the CNBC business updates each weekday at 9:30, 12:30, and 4:30. Now, your WCPT 820 Chicago traffic report.
The Friday slow jam underway. Now, the eastbound side of 8094 barely moves from the Tri-State over to Burr. Westbound on the brakes from the Indiana Toll Road back over to Kennedy Avenue. Coming in on the Edens up to 44 minutes, Lake Cook Road to the junction. Outbound in 28. Kennedy outbound 29 to the split, 20 in the express, 52 to the airport. Inbound from O'Hare, hour 4, 41 minutes off the junction. Eisenhower in either direction, hour 10 between 390 and the circle. I-55 north and south, bumper to bumper approaching Blodgett with road work leaving traffic only with one lane. Now in the Stevenson, if you're traveling outbound, that's bumper to bumper all the way out to Cass Avenue. Lakeshore Drive out to 355 an hour and 16, inbound at 57. Dan Ryan is 36 out, 29 of the reverse. That's traffic. I'm Mary DeBanges.
This is WCPT 820, where facts matter.
Joan Esposito, live, local, and progressive on WCPT 820.
I am going through Jim Peterik's schedule with him. We're trying to figure out where he's going to be performing so we know exactly the venues that we should be promoting on this show. And we've already told you that he's going to be at the Genesee Theater. But he buried the lead. He's got breaking news about that show that he's kept under wraps until now.
I think it's the first time we're announcing it because the deal's just happening. We're going to be filming this, videotaping. I guess they call it taping.
I don't know what they call it anymore.
We're going to be taping a cable special called Play On, One Magic Night. And so everybody in the audience, man, is going to be there on the video.
Immortalized.
Immortalized forever.
Wow.
And it's going to be exciting. The lights, we're pulling out all the stops.
Oh, that's going to be so cool.
With video screens, LEDs. It's going to be fabulous.
And I'm not afraid to give our not really competition a little plug too. You're going to be on Windy City Live.
Yeah, yeah. We've done.
Now, you are the whole band.
The whole band. Wow. 8-piece band. Full brass, the whole bit. October 24th, I think it's noon or 1 o'clock, I can't remember now, we'll be on Windy City Live with our good friend, Ryan Cheverini and the whole cast and Val. And we love those people. They always do great for us. So that's the day before the show.
And, you know, I'm good friends with Dina Bear from the WGN.
After, yes.
We've got to get you on there, too. I'm going to give Dina a call.
Thank you.
Say, come on.
Let's do it.
You got to have these guys on. We'll make this happen.
Okay.
Yes. I'm Jim's manager,
yes,
by the way.
Are.
I did not disclose
NPR.
That.
NPR. And we are doing Berwynfest, Oktoberfest, tomorrow.
Really?
Yeah. And right on Stanley Avenue, they're blocking off the street. They expect 10,000 people. This is our homecoming. We're all from Berwyn, all born at the same hospital across the street from where we're playing.
Wow.
So it's a coming home.
And how long have you had purple hair?
8 years.
Really?
Every month, I go to Ross at Salon Hype, and he purples me.
It's that's hard to do when you've got dark hair, though.
I know. They bleach it to white.
Yeah, and then they put the color in.
Yes.
It takes like hours and hours, doesn't it?
2.5, 3 hours.
Yeah.
And I bring, my computer, my iPhone, I do business, and he's putting the purple on, and it's a trademark, that's all.
Okay,
I like the color.
We have, you were great. It says, Jim, you were great on Channel 11, the cornerstone of rock. Will you do that again this year?
Yes.
What is that?
That's all the great bands from the 60s, Chicago, Ides of March, Buckingham's, New County, Six, Crying Shames, Shadows of Night, all on the same stage together. And we sell out all the time. We have a show at the Arcata in November, I think November 30th. Check out the Arcata website for the Cornerstones of Rock.
Where is that?
Arcata's in St. Charles.
Huh.
Really great theater. Ron Onesti runs it. He gets in so many great bands. A lot of bands that have been forgotten by time, and he brings them back and they pack the house.
So that night, is it just you guys or is it everybody?
It's everybody. It's the Ides of March of the backing band. Then we bring out Jimmy Sons of the Shadows of Night and we do Gloria.
Oh, I love that song.
I know,
that
we get
song.
Everybody a spelling lesson. The Buckinghams are self-contained. They come out on the second set, but we back up all the other bands from New County 6. I will always think about you, even if I live without you. Just beautiful stuff.
Wonderful, all those songs. Oh, you guys are so busy.
We are, and that's the way we like it, I've been married for 47 years, so my wife is kind of used to it.
Your wife must be a saint.
She's a very busy girl in her own business. So,
you guys, I don't know how often you are in the rest of the country, but touring, which is kind of a vital part of what you do for a living, it's really hard to keep those marriages, to keep family relationships, unless you've got a situation where your wife and kids can tour with you. That's really hard to do.
It is difficult. The 80s was a blur, and it wasn't because of drugs or booze. We were just on the road constantly. And I'd come home, and Karen and I would be strangers until we kind of adapted again. And that was not what I wanted with the Ides resurgence. So we choose our battles, and we don't tour 100, 150 dates a year like 38 Special my good friends do. I can't do that. We'll do maybe 45 shows, and it's doable. It's all about balance.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Well, that's what somebody was talking about, the Stones, that they just do short tours. It's not that big, we're going to spend 2 years going around the world twice stuff anymore. We have a caller who wants to ask you a question.
Yes.
Hey, Jim.
Hey, Dave, you got a question for Jim?
Hey, yeah, I just I wanted to say hi. I wanted to tell you a funny story about your music. We have a mutual friend, by the way, a guy who does a lot of your filming, Greg Bizarro. Anyway, I just wanted to say hi. This was years and years ago. A buddy's band was playing at a bar in the Upper Peninsula, and somebody started heckling them, saying, "Play some Skynyrd, man, play some Skynyrd," and thought he was really funny, of course. And so my buddy, kept saying, "Ha, ha, ha, never heard that before, great." And so the guy wouldn't stop, so then my buddy said, "This one goes out to my friend here. He's been requesting this song," and then all of a sudden he just started, and everybody's hands in the bar started throwing punch, in the air, and everybody started laughing at this guy, and it really embarrassed him, and they ended up playing the whole song, and the whole bar was up dancing and acting like they were boxing, and I just thought it was a funny story. And
as long as none of the punches landed, I think it's okay. But that's a cool story. And yeah, Greg Bizarro is our main video guy.
Thank you, Dave.
And we love him. Thank you.
You know, you played with Yo-Yo Ma?
Yes.
One of my heroes.
Oh, mine too. It was a crazy thing. It was a surprise. We were at the Pritzker Pavilion, and Little Kids Rock is a organization of little kids who rock, and they're just amazing. It's a great organization. It's all, you know, .org. It's, you know, all benefit. And I've been involved with them for about 10 years, and they called me up and said, we're opening up for Yo-Yo Ma. And I said, that's fantastic. And what we want to do is surprise them at the end and surprise the audience. You come on, and you and Yo-Yo Ma would do Eye of the Tiger at the end. And at soundcheck, and I didn't know Yo-Yo Ma, big fans, he got a lot of his records.
Yeah.
But he was so funny and so nice, and we got along just like old friends. And, you know, we practiced Eye of the Tiger, and I would play, you know, a lick, you know. And he'd jump, we're trading back and forth. It's on YouTube. You got to check it out.
Wow.
And Facebook. And so he did his three-hour concert of all this Bach, wonderful Bach stuff. Just he, just solo. And then he brings out Little Kids Rock and me, and the audience is going, who's this freak with the purple hair? And these little kids are amazing musicians. And we go into Eye of the Tiger. And all these stayed, you know, a lot of the audience is like, they're expecting classical music. They woke up real fast.
I guess
and
so.
And they got up on their feet and they're punching their, you know, they're rocking. And that was one of the greatest moments. And I do this thing, Joan, where I play my guitar behind my head because I can. And Yo-Yo Ma surprised me and he puts his cello behind his head. It's
no.
on the video. Yes. So it was, and we're still in touch with each other. It's just a wonderful thing.
Wow. We are going to take a real quick commercial break. And when we come back, we have a couple more people who have calls. They want to weigh in. We are talking with Jim Peterik. It is the 55th anniversary. No, it can't be. That's got to be a misprint. The 25th anniversary.
You know what? When I lie about my age, I usually add a year.
Yeah. Well, you know, I used to do that, too, because I said I'd rather have people think that I look really good for like 85 rather than giving my true age. Yeah.
Oh, man.
Okay. The 55th anniversary of the Ides of March, and they are going to be playing at the Genesee Theater in Waukegan. We are going to be back with more of this interview. Jim, you want to give us 30 seconds of something we can play us out with?
Hey, well, I'm a friend of a stranger in the black sedan. Hop inside my car. I got pictures, and I'm a lovable man. Take it to the nearest stop. I'm your vehicle, baby. I'll take you anywhere you want to go. I'm your vehicle, woman. By now, I'm sure you know. I need you, I want you, got to have your child. Great God in heaven, you know I love you. Ba-da-ba-ba-da.
Warning, this product contains nicotine. Nicotine is an addictive chemical, not for sale to minors. Website restricted to adults 21 and over.
Let's be real. Most smokers aren't looking for some overcomplicated vaping machine. That's why we created MyBlue. MyBlue is simple. Our pre-filled liquid pods mean there's no mess. One charge and MyBlue lasts all day. And with our range of flavors and nicotine options, you have a choice. MyBlue answers on what matters for smokers. Real nicotine satisfaction. And right now, try MyBlue for $1 at select retailers or MyBlue.com.
If you or someone you know is struggling with addiction, please call this toll-free number right now. 800-390-9528. That's 800-390-9528. By calling your addiction team, you're taking the first steps to recovery. The help you need could be one call away. 800-390-9528. Make the free call now. 800-390-9528. Your addiction team is a third-party advertiser for various treatment centers and placement networks. Individual results will vary. Visit youraddictionteam.com/terms for more information.
My name is David Hochberg of Team Hochberg. If you're looking to refinance, please call Team Hochberg. Mike, self-employed, lives in a million-dollar home in Glenview, called to refinance and combined his $500,000 expiring adjustable-rate mortgage and $100,000 HELOC. Mike planned on moving when his daughter graduates high school in 5 years, so to help Mike afford his constantly increasing and ridiculously expensive real estate taxes, I recommended an interest-only loan. Mike was hesitant at first, but after I explained his monthly payment would decrease over $1,100 a month, he told us to immediately get the ball rolling. If you're interested in lowering your monthly mortgage payment, like Mike, call the local mortgage experts right now on Team Hochberg at 855-56-DAVID or visit 56david.com. Team Hochberg has helped thousands of WCPT listeners, but we can't help if you don't call 855-56-DAVID. That's 855-56-DAVID or visit 56david.com.
Homeside Financial, Equal Housing Lender, Illinois Residential Mortgage Licensee, MB 6676-1019, NMLS 1124061.
You're listening to WCPT 820 because facts matter.
Joan Esposito,
live, local, and progressive
on WCPT 820.
It is the 55th anniversary of the forming of the Ides of March, and to commemorate that, they, of course, did a new album. It's called Play On. They're going to be playing that and all their hits when they are at the Genesee Theater Saturday, October 26th. If you want tickets, you can go to GeneseeTheater.com. Grab your headphones now.
All right, will do.
So we're going to, I don't know how, they might be a little loud. I kind of went crazy with
the volume. We're good.
And I was telling you in the commercial that my partner Ray has followed your career. He's on the phone now. Hey. Hello, Ray.
Hey, Ray.
Hey. Hi. Hey, Jim. I'm a huge fan. I just admire you so much. And I congratulate you. Writing songs is not easy, and writing hit songs is almost impossible. And so you should be very proud of yourself. You've had a great career, and I'm sure it's going to keep going for many more years.
Oh, come on. Tell him the truth that you opened for him when you were a teenager.
Well, we did. We played with you at Papa Joe's.
Oh, yes.
In Park Ridge. Uh-huh. And you had a band at the time called the Chi-Town Hustlers.
Yes, I know. Yes.
Peterik and the Chi-Town Hustlers. But you were good. You had a bunch of female singers. It was great.
Right, right.
And we loved opening for you, but actually I wanted to mention too, I don't know if you remember this, you played a Battle of the Bands in the late 60s at Carnes Music. Do you remember that in Niles?
No.
Well, I think you guys won because that's where I studied guitar lessons.
And
I remembered their newsletter and it showed you guys and it said you won the Battle of the Bands at Carnes Music.
Oh my God.
I think it was 67 or 68 and I thought that was so cool. And then shortly after that, you guys exploded.
Oh
so,
man. I remember Carnes Music, but I don't remember that one, but I don't remember a few things, you know, but I do remember Papa Joe's. And what was the name of, your band, Ray?
Our band was called Forest, F-O-R-E-S-T. We were like progressive rock, but we had a great time opening for it. We were a very proud moment for us. So anyway, that's all I wanted to say. Thanks for being on the show.
Okay, Ray. Thanks so much for checking in.
And Getty is calling from Old Town. Hey, Getty.
It's Debbie. Hi, how are you today?
I'm good.
Good. Hey, we saw you. We went down to see Yo-Yo Ma.
Yes.
And, you know, we listened to this very amazing dry concert, box suites, you know, a couple of hours of it. We were blown away by Yo-Yo Ma. And when it was all over, everybody was like, okay, we're going to go. And then all of a sudden, the curtain goes up and the stage starts to build. And you come out, and Yo-Yo comes out, and the crowd went crazy. I mean, it was just like, it was, you know, and then with the guitars, like you said, with the guitar over your head, and then his cello over his head.
Oh, like man.
Hendrix.
It was one of the best days of my life. You know, one of the, you know, four or five highlights was that night. It was so much fun. I can't even tell you.
Thanks so much for calling and sharing that memory.
Yeah, awesome. Thank you.
Well, you kind of played it down. She said the crowd went wild. You were like, they don't know who I am. That isn't quite right, Mr. Peterik.
I didn't want to oversell it. You know.
Well, you'll never get anywhere in the business if you don't start hyping yourself.
That's the problem.
So one of the things that I wanted to ask you at the beginning of this interview, when you said that Sylvester Stallone just reached out to you, and there was a voice on the answering machine. How did he ever tell you how he picked you?
Yes. We were on a label, record label called Scotti Brothers, distributed by Atlantic. And Scotti Brothers, they were Italian. And, you know, the Italians, there's thick as thieves, no pun intended.
And yes, we are. Thank you very much.
And they're very loyal to each other. And anyway, Tony Scotti, well, very good friends with Frank Stallone and Sly. And Sly came to the office one day, said, I need a new sound, you know. And Tony Scotti says, well, we got this band. They're called Survivor. And they haven't broken yet, but they really got a sound. And he played Stallone a song from our second album called Poor Man's Son. He goes, that's the sound I want.
Really?
Yeah. And Tony gave him my number. The rest is history.
Wow. Wow. That's amazing. It's just amazing how things happen.
Oh, I know.
Isn't it?
You know what? Sometimes it starts with one phone call. It's just crazy. Spider webs from there.
It absolutely does. I saw an interview with William Shatner, and he said, you know, people gave him a lot of grief when he did that album, which was kind of talky.
Mr. Tambourine Man. It was cool. Yeah.
But he said, you know, I got a lot of grief for doing that, but somebody, like some young person, heard that and later became like a film director and called him up because they remembered that album and they were like, that this guy could work. And he's like, you can't imagine the work I've gotten because of that album that everybody made fun of.
I know. You know, and he was dead serious. You know, it was on an album they kind of put out on Rhino called Golden Throats, and it was kind of like a parody. And is he serious? Yes, he was.
Jim, how come you never went Hollywood?
I like Chicago. I really do. I love the Cubs and Sox and the Bulls and the Blackhawks and pan pizza and the people. You know, I never moved. I mean, I spent a lot of time all around the world, L.A., Nashville, New York. Never fit me. Never felt at home. And I come home and I'm more creative in Chicago.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you think that it's affected your career? Because I know I've known for years Victor Skrzybnewski, who is one of the iconic photographers
yes.
of his generation. And I think that Victor or the people around him always felt that if he had only moved to New York, you know, he would have been in the same breath as Richard Avedon. And here in Chicago, he is
yes.
in the same breath as Richard Avedon, but not necessarily in other places. Do you think that staying here has held you back in any way?
Well, it might have, but my peace of mind's more important. And feeling like myself and feeling like I'm in the right place and around family and familiarity, that's more important to me than how big I can be. And I feel great about it.
And, you know, it's not like you've done badly.
Right.
I mean, anybody who can collect cars
and
is
guitars.
Not doing... And guitars?
Well, guitar is my main thing. I have almost 200 guitars.
Really? What's your favorite?
I like Gibsons. I like Les Pauls, Firebirds. I like Fender Telecasters, Stratocasters, Martin Acoustics, Gibson Acoustics.
Do you have a favorite?
I like the first good guitar I ever have. It's my favorite. It's a Les Paul Gold Top from 1968. I saved up money. I bought it at Guitar Gallery, not Guitar Center. This was on Wabash, across the street from Lion Healy. I put it on layaway, and when I got it, it became my vehicle. And that's the guitar I recorded Vehicle on. I still have it. I used it this morning. It goes around me all over the world.
What a great story. And what's your favorite car?
I like my 1955 Chevy Bel Air convertible.
Oh, that's a beauty.
It's beauty. It's
what
kind of
color
that
is it?
Coral and cream.
Ooh.
It's so sexy. And I go down the street, and the kids are going, is that from Mars?
You
know, they don't know what it is.
What's that boxy convertible down the street
in
pastel colors?
They love it. And I have a 58 Corvette, same color scheme. Mid condition. Lamborghini, I told you, that's my midlife cruiser. And I love it.
Sounds like you're having a lot of fun.
Oh, I am. And I got grandkids now, I was telling you, Maisie and Colby. Grandkids are great because you can give them back at the end of the day. You know, and Colin and Meredith are great parents. And My wife Karen's having a lot of fun.
Do you babysit?
Yeah.
Do you sing to them?
All the time. If Colby's crying, I'll do Eye of the Tiger.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, and he loves Eye of the Tiger. See? Start him young.
That's so amazing. So you don't play like lullabies or...
Oh, man. That doesn't work. They want the Eye of the Tiger, baby.
And tell me about your son.
He's a multi-talented singer-songwriter. He's got a new Steely Dan cover band called Brooklyn Charmers. They're tearing up the place. They sold out the Wildy Theater in Edwardsville near St. Louis two nights in a row. They're fabulous, and really proud of him.
You sound like you're proud of him.
Good kid.
Well, he's got a good dad.
Thank you.
You know, I mean, you have had tremendous success. You have every right to have a star vibe. Don't come close to me. Don't touch me. Don't talk to me. And you have instead a Midwest vibe. And I agree with you. There's nothing better than a Midwest vibe.
And you got it too. Thank you for having me. This was so much fun.
Well, you're very welcome. It was a lot of fun for me too. You know, we do a lot of issues in politics, and the way the world is now, sometimes by the end of the week, I'm just ready to throw myself in front of a bus.
Yeah.
And you know, you are saving a life today.
Thank you. I'm glad. You know, sometimes I turn on CNN. Big mistake. You know, it's just, I can't take it. You know, in a way, I like to get into my music. I don't want to, you know, wall myself off from reality. Sometimes you have to. It's so crazy.
You need a break from it periodically. Yep. And this has been our break. It has been Fun Friday. We've had a great week. I want to thank all of you who listen, who call, who text. I am so glad to finish this week with Jim Peterik. Remember, Genesee Theater, October 26th, GenesseeTheater.com. Thanks to everybody here. Thanks to Tony Porter. Thanks to George Bliss for making this happen. He is a wonderful human being, and we love him. Remember, the Rick Unger Show is next. Santita Jackson will be here Monday at 6 a.m. And I will, of course, God willing and the crick don't rise, as my mother used to say.
Mine too.
Be here Monday at 2 p.m. And Jim, take us out.
All right. Okay, here we go. Little song I wrote with 38 Special. Yeah, baby. A little advice that I got from a girl that I used to date, who's now my wife. Hold on loosely, but don't let go. You see it all around you. Good loving gone bad. And usually it's too late when you realize what you have.